Hey guys, how's it going? PaleoJaw here, and it's time for Prehistoric Animal of the Month. This month's animal is Megaloceras, suggested by Expetra Patronum. Any further ado, let's begin. Megaloceras, also known as the Irish elk or giant deer, lived in Ireland, Asia, Europe, and even in China. Ever since Baron Georges Cuvier, I really hope I said that right. Anyways, when he published studies on giant deer in the late 1700s and early 1800s, Megaloceras has shown up in a variety of media, scientific studies, the star of paleo artworks, and popular texts, to name a few. For roughly 200 years, this animal has thrived in paleontology and mainstream culture. To start with, they weighed about 600 kilograms and stood roughly 2 meters high at the shoulder. They also hold the record for the largest antlers on any form of deer known, that being 3.5 meters across. But even though it's easy to see them as a giant elk and simply stop there's much more to them than you might think. To start with, it was an ice age species that avoided the cold. Instead, they did much better in open, flat, and well-watered settings called boreal parklands, where they ate all kinds of plants like pine and spruce trees, shrubs, and herbs. It also wasn't even an elk at all, despite its common name. Right now they're placed in the Cervinae clade, also known as Old World deer. And with great deer comes great speed. Thanks, Uncle Ben. Anyways, Megaloceras was no couch potato when it came to running. In fact, they might have actually been the most cursorial of any deer, meaning they're incredibly well designed for running far and long over wide open ground. In fact, Canadian biologist Valerius Geist thought Megaloceras could have ran at 80 kilometers per hour, or 50 miles per hour for us Americans, and once at cruising speed, they might have been capable of running for hours and hours without even stopping. Antler size is a direct reflection of their health, so it stands to reason that they would have been the fittest and fastest. Young Megaloceras would have also needed to be fast, strong, and coordinated to get away from danger and keep up with their parents. In a blog post made by one of my all-time favorite paleo artists, Mark Witten, he states that these factors mean Megaloceras wasn't a fast deer that happened to have huge antlers, but rather its antlers were actually a direct consequence of its hypercursorial lifestyle. Another cool aspect besides their giant antlers is the way they've been shown in paleo art. The first true paleo art of Megaloceras was actually cave paintings, which showed them as potentially having dark colors at the shoulder hump that taper into stripes across the body and neck. But those paintings are still not very easy to interpret, since the stripes could have also been boundaries between color regions or something else entirely. But besides those paintings, the coloring is honestly just up to the individual depicting them. For example, Geist, the guy who proposed the idea of them running 80 kilometers per hour, considered them to be pale all over with a dark body stripe. However, American paleontologist Dale Guthrie depicted them as having more regionalized coloring, with darker hindquarters fading into paler hues around the shoulder, framed by stripes. But before then, Megaloceras was almost always depicted with colors like red deers or elk, which weren't exactly original. Now for a more disheartening topic. Why are they no longer with us? The answer to this question is still debated. The idea of their giant antlers quite literally pulling them down to extinction has recently been thrown out the window for obvious reasons, but there are many other ideas. Environmental change, their high productivity demands, and human hunting could have all played a part in their demise. The most logical idea is that their environment degraded due to the post-flood ice age, but they probably didn't die due to climate change alone. Sadly, our ancestors may have also played a part, since even small amounts of hunting may have been enough to push Megaloceras over the edge. Now, while I could definitely talk more about Megaloceras, I think that'll have to be it for June's Prehistoric Animal of the Month. Honestly, this was a pretty cool animal to research and study for this video. Also, a special thanks to Valerius Geist, Dale Guthrie, and Mark Witten for the research of this awesome animal. Oh, and before I go, if you want to see your favorite prehistoric animal featured on this series, make sure to follow me on Instagram at paleodraw_yt, and be on the lookout for Instagram stories where you can send me suggestions. Now of course if you like this video, make sure to give that like button a tap, and if you're new here and kinda like this kind of stuff, subscribe so that way you don't miss on a new upload. And as always, keep your pencils sharp.